Hello students, till now we have discussed in the transportation geography about the national highways, national waterways and the seaport. Today in this lecture we are going to discuss about the railways. How railways helps us to transport in the different locations of a country and how it is fruitful for the transportation. So before we start about the railways, we should know some basic points, basic history of the railways, that the first railway, from where it was started and in which year it was started. In India, the first train was run on 22nd December 1851. 1851, 22nd December को सबसे पहली ट्रेन रन हुई थी, जिस कहाँ पे कहाँ से, मुंबई से लेके थेन तक. And it was for a short distance that was only 33.6 kilometers long. So the first point is important, that the first railway, the first train ran between the Mumbai and the Thane during the British era. So this is one of the important point about the railways. By the year, as year passed away, then it got into development stage, and later on we even developed the first electric train of India, that is called the Deccan Queen. This is also important with the perspective of the exam, that which is the first electric train, that is called Deccan train. And the first electric train is named as Deccan Queen, and it runs between Mumbai and Pune. Again, these two cities are located in the state of the Maharashtra. I hope you are clear with these two things. In the year 1951, the Indian Railways were nationalized. That means the development of the railways got into the hands of the government of India. That was nationalized in the year 1951. So another important point, because after that era, after the year of 1951, the government of India started the initiative to improve the railway sector by increasing its networking from one city to another. It started connecting different mountain region, forest, villages to each other. Villages like in Madhya Pradesh, mountain region in the northeast, and the villages in every state. So they have started interlinking each city with each other with respect to the railways. Railways are helpful to carry out the bulky goods, heavy loads. You have seen in the railway station that there are bogies which carry the heavy loads from one place to another. It helps us to carry the passengers from one place to another. It makes easy to travel. Even for the middle class family, it is easier way to travel through the railways. So it is one of the important transportation in the life and in the geography. Okay, so these were the basic points about the railways. Now let us come to the types of railway lines. This is one of the important topic. You should know what are the types of railway lines. It is, the first is the broad gauge, the second is the meter gauge, and this third is narrow gauge. So what is the basic difference between these type of gauge? Before we move on, first of all we should know the meaning of gauge. The meaning of gauge is, suppose this is one rail, this is second rail, and in between this a train runs. Can you see this drawing clearly visible hai? Okay, so iske beech mein aapki ट्रेन चलती है. सो ये डिस्टेंस बिटवीन दीज टू रेल्स होता है, इसको बोलते हैं गॉज. तो अब आपको सारे मतलब पता चल जाएंगे कि हम लोग क्या करने वाले. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड द ब्रॉड गॉज. ब्रॉड गॉज मीन्स कि जो इसका जो डिस्टेंस है वो अच्छा खासा होगा, ब्रॉड होगा. ब्रॉड गॉज का डिस्टेंस होता है 5 feet 6 inch. सो ब्रॉड गॉज इट ऑपरेट्स इन एरियाज. दिस इज इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड. कौन से एरियाज में, हाउ वी विल सिलेक्ट कि हमको ब्रॉड गॉज रखना है, नैरो गॉज रखना है या फिर मीटर गॉज रखना है. सो इनिशियली द ब्रॉड गॉज जो था, इट ऑपरेट्स इन एरियाज वेयर देयर इज अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज, वेयर देयर इज अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज, एंड इट ट्रांसपोर्ट्स हैवी मिनरल्स लाइक आयरन, कोल, मिनरल ऑयल, फर्टिलाइजर्स. सो दीज वर द इम्पॉर्टेंट मिनरल्स विच यूज टू बी ट्रांसपोर्ट फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर. फॉर दीज पर्पसेज वी यूज टू कंस्ट्रक्ट ब्रॉड gauge. Okay, I hope you are clear with this broad gauge. The second term is meter gauge. It is time consuming and expensive. Meter gauge bana to diye gaye the, but it was found ki ye ek to time consuming hai aur expensive bhi humko padta hai rather than broad gauge. Okay, and its distance is almost 1 meter, or you can say it is 1000 mm. So later on government started one initiative, that is known as Project Unicorch in the year 1992. This is one of the important initiative because under this project, Unigorch, Uni matlab single gorge, that means the government has decided to convert all the meter gorge into the broad gorge. This is very, very important point. The existing meter gorge, they wanted to convert into broad gorge because the meter gorge gives the meter gorge cost expensive and it is less worthy. So they wanted to transfer into broad gorge. Now let us see what is the railway scenario in the state of Rajasthan. Okay, Rajasthan. सबसे पहला point जो आता है कि total railway network जो हमारा country India के अंदर है, उसका 11% हमारे Rajasthan state के अंदर है. Rajasthan is having 11% of the network in the state of Rajasthan, and the broad gauge accounts for 71% at national level. If we compare the broad percentage, broad gauge percentage all over the country, then Rajasthan has 71% of broad gauge. And if we compare the all the networking lines in the state itself, then it accounts 50% broad gauge is 50% in the state itself. अगर आप परसेंटेज विद रिस्पेक्ट टू राजस्थान निकालते हैं देन इट अकाउंट्स 50%, और अगर आप कंपेयर करते हो विद द रिस्पेक्ट ऑफ द होल कंट्री देन इट अकाउंट्स 71%. सो आई होप यू आर क्लियर विद दिस रेलवेज ऑल्सो. सो इफ यू लाइक द वीडियो प्लीज डू शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब एंड कॉमेंट इन द कॉमेंट बॉक्स. थैंक यू सो मच.